7:49 at KPEL. Welcome back to Acadiana's Morning News with Rob and Bernie. And still in studio with us this morning, Jackie Russo, every Monday morning. Okay, community partnerships. You know, there's a lot of things that we do, especially in Acadiana, festivals, farmers markets, different things like that. And when you're there, you see that there's a business that has tied itself to it, whether it's funding or tents, something, maybe for a farmers market or something. And these ultimately just align a business with what I want to do in my daily life. What's the benefit of this?
Well, it's twofold. One, it truly is about giving back to the community. It's about finding a way to help a cause that needs to be helped, that maybe is something that's close, near, and dear to your heart, or you see a deficiency or deficit you need to fix or correct. And then secondly, it does ultimately benefit your business because you're getting your name out there, you're being associated with a great cause. But what we see and what is so interesting to us is the number of nonprofits that exist in Acadiana, because we're kind of stacked with them. But we don't have, you know, I think we look at Acadiana as being so generous and people being so kind, and I think that's absolutely true. But we don't have legacy donors. We don't have people giving money like we do in other communities. You know, if you drive through a major metropolis, everything's going to be named after somebody because they gave big bucks for the legacy and help a cause. You don't see that here. There's very few naming opportunities that have occurred and huge public-private partnerships. And so we, I think, give generously and care and make sure that food pantries are stocked and can drives occur, but we don't have big dollars. And so what we looked at was some of the bigger opportunities around where people have truly given and made sure to make a bad problem worse. And so General Mills is one of the first things, and that's not one of the legacy naming opportunities, but that's a company that said, we're going to step up and we're going to put our money where our mouth is and really help people. And so they did the Save Lids for Lives campaign. Yeah. And so you could pull the yogurts, right, and turn them in. And over $25 million have been donated through that.
Yeah.
And so that was about raising awareness. Something that was simple and easy to remember and easy to do. It wasn't a complicated seven-step process and really helped people.
Yeah.
And so that's what I want. I challenge Acadiana to look bigger and to really say, you know, how can we step up and really help people in this community?
Do you think maybe it's because organizers of things like this or maybe certain nonprofits just can't see the long term, like to put a dollar amount to say this amount, I will call it these awards forever?
Yes.
I mean,
I think that's a big part of it.
I would imagine that would be a fear for me, just saying, okay, I don't know if it's $10,000. I don't know if it's $100,000. And I don't know what donors I'm going to get for it. So that's why it is, because you're right. It's more of a yearly thing. This year, you know, XOXO Festival brought to you by this person this year.
Right.
And that's going to change next year, likely.
Well, and I would tell you that I think I'm starting to see a little bit of that. James Munkus should get some credit. He's really stepped up and said, I'm gonna start this here. And so, you know, we're starting to maybe see that happen. But I have to believe he's not the only person in Acadiana who has the capacity to do that. Mm-hmm. And so how else as a company or as an individual can you step up and say, I'm going to take this little corner of the world and make it better?
Yeah.
And this is how.
Yeah.
And it's important. I think it's one of the things that we get a great reputation for being kind and generous, but we need to do more.
I think that, you know, when you are a local company, that you a big part of your appeal is that you're local.
Right.
You know, we see that a lot with, you know, you might have the Best Buys and, you know, other places you can buy electronics, but you also have local electronics stores. Differentiating yourself from that, just to, that you're local, is sometimes not enough.
Right.
So maybe putting yourself in other places, whether it's with a school fundraiser or something that's an ongoing thing, kind of a good way to go.
Absolutely. Well, I had the opportunity to go to Lafayette Middle School. That's a Leader in Me school. Mm-hmm. And so they were showing off after their first few months of participating in the program, which is incredible. And every school should have a Leader in Me component to it. Oh, it's amazing. And Allison Elkubi has done an incredible job there, really turning that school around. But it was awesome to see they had a very clear vision of what they need for help and support. And so they invited community leaders in to say, this is what we need from you. We need $600 for this. And we need $7,000 for that. And we need $4,200 for this. And we need $187.63 for this. Mm-hmm. And so it was a very specific list of wants and needs. So I think it starts there. You've got to know what you need.
Yeah.
And then you've got to reach out to the people who can help you. And the community needs to respond.
And how many times we hear, teachers especially, there are so many websites where teachers go to write grants or to just say, we have this project, we need funded. And yeah, it ultimately comes through. I have a friend who had a big iPad thing. I think they got 20 iPads, but it was totally underwritten by Jeff Bezos, had gone through and said, here's all this money, pick, you know, and so they picked all these, and that's who did it. Why can't it not be a local company that does it?
It can and should.
It can and should. All right, absolutely. Well, we're going to put all this information up. Really good information, no matter what the size of your business is, really. I will put it up on KPL965.com.